out on an extremely stifling hot kind of day. Could be worse though. And there is virtually no movement. So everything that you see happening is hard work done by these guys getting it put together. There we go. So he's got this one going. And what he's trying to do is we're trying to get the whole area eventually cycling. Every last one of these going around. Joel is now going in to aid. Alright, now we're moving. Okay, so we've gotten basically all this from zero movement to where it is now. Excellent work being done. We're going to try to do here, we're going to try to get it to where it's just constantly moving, and then we're going to bring it back down on command. Now Joel just did that, brought it down, and now he's going to push it right back in. But that's the thing, is what we want to do is get constant flow. Now notice that behind Joel has his, Daniel has his. He has one, two here. Those two are both moving. When Joel stopped, both those two stopped moving. Important stuff to see. Especially when it comes to the behaviors. Now look, Joel is concentrating on the other one now, and we have movement going there. Just like that. Excellent maneuverability there. Took a little while to get them going, but now they're going. And as Joel is moving in and out, I can feel the flushing. That's what I call a flush wave. Just opening up his energy and then in and out and then just pushing it back outward to the environment. Perfect. Now look how all the windmills are just responding absolutely magnificently. So now we have like perfect movement, like it's nice and breezy out here, whereas before it was really stagnant and humid and just hot.